Hello, hello, Andrea Majeski here with Dentalelle Tutoring. So I've been getting a lot of emails this week specifically about students or dental hygienists who have or who are working in offices that they just don't know if it's the proper dynamic, if they're doing the right things, if they're not doing the right things, you know, that type of thing. So this video is about what you do when you're in an office that you don't like. I don't know how else to say it, but you're just not happy there, but you don't know if it's just you overreacting, if it's like, okay, things have got to change. Because I find as dental professionals, we work so hard. We will stick it out, do whatever we can. We're not the type of professionals that just simply leave an office because we're having a bad day or because we're having a bad week. And we just say, too bad, so sad, life is too short, I am out of here. We're not those types of people. And I have a perfect example. I was in the same office for 12 years. I loved it. I didn't ever think of leaving. Yes, I had some good days. I had some bad days. I had some horrible days, even when things got really, really bad at one point. Because staff was changing, doctors were changing, hours were changing. It was just a big mess. I didn't even think for a second that I had other options out there. But I'll admit now, to be perfectly honest, maybe it's just because I've been doing this for about 14 years now. I've moved a couple times. Even when I moved an hour out of town, I still worked in the same office. I didn't even think things would be easier to just go work somewhere else, right? But now my mentality is different. So I tend to tell people when you're first starting out, it's just things are so overwhelming. Things are crazy overwhelming where, you know, staff, you might not mesh with staff right away, but that might be normal. It takes time. You might be lucky to work in an office where you just mesh with everybody right away. And that's how I felt when I first started as a dental assistant. Maybe I was just lucky. I worked for a great dentist. I did reception, I did assisting, I loved it. I got along with everybody, so it seemed. I just loved it. But I'm hearing from a lot of people, you know, they might be in a new office where they don't get along with everybody. They feel like everybody's putting all of the work on them. They work so hard, yet they're not being appreciated. These things do happen, unfortunately. So you might be wondering, well, do I stay? Do I leave? Am I overreacting? So I might go back and forth on this a little bit because I do think it depends on who you are as well. And it depends on what stage you're at. You know, as a perfect example, again, no names mentioned. I'm going to try not to mention a name here, but I do know this person. She does not work in the dental profession. But she's the type where she works somewhere, she has a bad day, and she quits. And then she complains that she doesn't have any money. But again, she does not work in the dental profession. So if that sounds like you, that's not a good thing because not every job is perfect. Okay. I mean, no job is perfect. You might have a bad day, but it depends on why the day is bad. Okay. So if you're working in an office now where, and again, this is just my opinion, but if you're working in an office where you work so hard, you show up early every day, you stay late every night because other staff members aren't pulling their weight, that's when things get tricky. That is when I tend to tell people, look for something else because it's not going to get better. It might, but from my experience, you can't change another person. You can only change you. If you try to talk to your boss, you know, saying like, listen, I come in early, I don't get a thank you. I stay late, I don't get a thank you. I'm doing the work of five people, whereas the other, you know, workers are sitting in the back having a coffee or they're complaining that I'm not working enough yet I'm working harder than them. So if it's that type of dynamic and the boss isn't doing anything about it, I suggest leaving. I suggest looking for something else and then obviously leaving after that. But again, this is just my opinion. I don't want to tell people to leave. In the end, it depends on you. What do you feel in your heart? I get a lot of people tell me, I love the office so much, but I'm exhausted every day. I have to work so hard because other people aren't pulling their weight, or I work so hard, I'm exhausted every day. I love it, but my boss isn't very nice and they make me feel horrible after every single day. If I do one little thing wrong, they pretty much yell at me, you know? So is that worth it? Is that worth it to work there every day and feel like that? I say no. I say look for something else quicker, you know, sooner rather than later. Now though, I'm the type of person where if I don't like an office, I'm going to leave. That's why I was a temp for about 6 months, because I wanted to kind of find an office that I really, really liked. But I think it was because after I left that office of 12 years, I worked in an office that was amazing for like 3 months, but then they hired a consultant who just made us work longer hours. We never got a lunch. We had to clock out like 10 minutes after our shift, even if we were still working, because the patient was behind. I wasn't getting paid. They were taking off money from my paycheck because they said that I was in too early, even though I had to come in at that point to do chart audits, all kinds of things. So that was a very icky dynamic. I didn't like it and I just left. I didn't, you know, tell them that's why I left, but admittedly it was a good time because we were actually moving. So I just said, hey, you know what, you guys, I love it here, but we're moving really, really fast. I gotta go. So that's just kind of how that happened. And then when I was temping in Kitchener, where I'm living now, I was working for different offices, and it was amazing to see how some offices, I just didn't want to work there. I would work there for a day and not want to go back because either they overbooked patients, they had really bad instruments to work with that I couldn't do my work properly, they didn't say thank you, you know, just things like that. Or I would work in offices that were amazing, where they were so happy to see me. I had the best instruments ever. When I needed a check, the dentist came in on time and didn't make me wait for like a half an hour and then wonder why I'm behind. So there are offices where you will just know if it's a good office or not. Or work there for 3 months, and that is when their true colors start to shine. Just to let you guys know, that seems to be the thing. So sorry, this is kind of a longer video, but what I tell people is to go with what you feel. Go with what you feel, as silly as that sounds. If you're, you know, almost sick to go into work every single day, it's not worth it. It's not worth it. But I'm not saying quit and then not have money. Look for something else. If you don't feel right doing that, talk to the boss. Let them know how you feel. If nothing changes, then it's time to leave. That's what I think. But do not be so quick to leave a job because you're having a bad day. Trust me, bad days happen. I have great days. I have bad days where I want to quit. I'm thinking, oh my God, patients were just awful today. I was 5 minutes behind. I get like yelled at, you know, just good days, bad days. It's normal. But go with what you think. Go with what you feel. If you're not looking forward to going into work, like if you just don't feel good, it's time to leave. No one looks forward to going into work, I don't think, but because we would just always rather be home and get paid for it. But if you don't feel good about it, like if you feel sick, it's time to leave. I hope this helped. Feel free to comment and let me know your good office experiences, your bad office experiences, what you do to kind of handle things. Because it does depend on many different factors. So sorry for the longer video. I just kind of feel like I'm talking to everybody here. So it's nice to vent a little bit and kind of talk about my experiences. So thank you guys for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe if you haven't yet, because I do upload videos often. Have a good Wednesday. I will see you guys next time.